Hello. See, you know what's wrong with our churches today? We've got a bunch of members, got a bunch of sacred cows. You change the sign, they're about ready to die. You stripe the parking lot, they about ready to die. Hey, by the way, we got more handicapped spots than anybody in the world. Walmart don't have many handicapped spots than we do. And by the way, there ain't no sacred cow parking lot spots out there. You have a handicapped sticker, you qualify. You don't, even if you got one and you don't wear it on your car, you get a ticket. And by the way, them people don't respect their persons. They give me a ticket the other day for crossing. I parked out outside the line, got a ticket. You said, you get mad? No. I just took it, put in my pocket, walked away. And some of y'all say, I don't like it. What? Hey, I liked it real well the other day when we had this man pass out and people were parked in the right place and they wasn't double parked. Right. Some of you better get off your little sacred cows. This is a big church. We're growing all the time. We're getting all kinds of different people in here. They may not even like, you may not even like how they look. But see, I ain't got no sacred calves. People are dying and going to hell. And churches, look at me, churches are majoring on the minors instead of the majors. Number two. I got 4 points and I ain't getting them done real fast. I'm almost done. I'll try to hurry. Will y'all stay 10 more minutes? If you leave, I'll call your name. The people that stoned him. Not only the preaching that stirred him, the people that stoned him, the truth that he shared, he told the truth about him. They were stiff-necked religionists. And the testimony that his face glowed. Well, I want to tell you what, when they looked at him, he said his face shined as an angel. Yeah. And then the traditions he squashed. Hold it. God have mercy. I wonder if God's going to judge us this week. I wonder if we're going to get the judgment of God. Because you know what we're going to do tonight? We're going to take up these seats. And they're going to be a bunch of little kids running in this building Wednesday night around that one circle. And by the way, when God gives us a new building, that'll be a basketball court. That's what it shows right there. Hello? You say, well, you mean tell me kids come down here and run and do a one on Wednesday night? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I ain't got nowhere to put them. You want me to tell them we don't want kids in church? You want me to tell them they ain't welcome? You want me to tell them they ought to just die and go to hell? You want me to tell them that they're not important people? You look right at me. Right there. That boy getting called to preach is enough for me to preach this morning. Somebody help me. I'll squash some of your tradition. By the way, I might as well say this. I've been wanting to say this for a long time. I had somebody one time. You ever have somebody, how many's ever met an idiot? I had an idiot. Just so happened I went back and shook hands. I quit doing that because too many idiots come to me. And I had an idiot come to me, jerked on my suit and said, I saw a little kid in the church with a cookie and some Kool-Aid. I think that's bad. You remember Jesus running them out of the temple. Do you have rocks for brains? He run them out of the temple for merchandise in the house of God, not drinking Kool-Aid and eating a cookie. See, all that is a bunch of tradition that ain't worth a nickel. I tell you what, one guy left the church over. I'm gonna tell you he did. He said he did. I don't know if that's true. I don't really think it's true. See this? Look up here. See this? How many of y'all know what that is? That's a bottle of Tyler Mountain Water. Delicious. They was somebody criticized the choir director and me for having a bottle of water. And he left the church because we had bottles of water. Shouldn't drink a bottle of water in church. That's disgusting. People are dying and going to hell, and you worrying about a bottle of water. I think I'll take a drink. Am I preaching? Oh, stones start flying. Number three, let me go. I got to give you this. I got to give you the good part. Verse 55, the power that strengthened him. But he being full of the Holy Ghost. Listen to me. How many of you Christians are full of the Holy Ghost? I'll know if you're here tonight. I know if you want to try to serve God. Not if you're working or have something with your children that's important. I ain't getting that. Do what you have to do. But if you ain't providentially hindered and ain't got something in the way, you ought to be out of church hearing this preacher preach. Because, see, we're full of the Holy Ghost. The only way you can fight people that throw rocks at you is get full of the Holy Ghost, and God got you. Because it gets nasty in the trenches. Well, you think when they felt pulling them rocks, so Stephen, the Bible said him being full of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Whew. Yeah, boy. I'm going to tell you something. Look at me, couples. You want your marriage to last? You get full of the Holy Ghost. You want your family to stay put? You get full of the Holy Ghost. You want to operate out in a business world and a business climate that hates you and hates Christians? You get full of the Holy Ghost. You can be a businessman and a contractor and go out there and do the best you can, and they still throw rocks at you. And you can't help what they say. You can rent property to them. You can do whatever to them. And you, just because you got rules, they want to throw rocks at you. But let me tell you how to withstand that bunch of hypocrites. It's when they start throwing them, just get full of the Holy Ghost. Am I preaching? Number four, and I'm done. Verse 56. Lord Jesus. This is the only time this is in the Bible. The person that secured him. He said, behold, look here. I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. Let me show you what happened. Look up here. I'm done. You said, what secured that old boy? I ain't seen this nowhere else in the Bible. But that old boy was getting rocks thrown at him. Some of y'all's having rocks thrown at you by your family, friends, schoolmates. You're under persecution all the time. Here's what I think happens. I think Jesus stands and looks over the balcony. Said, don't quit. I got you back. Somebody raise your hand if you thank God for him having you back. Let me tell you something. I would tell you not to trust in the economy. That's not going to secure you. I don't trust in politicians. They sure won't secure you. You said, preacher, when the battle's raging, when people get ugly at me and my children, when they throw rocks at me, what do? I just look up to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. He's up there standing, saying, oh, I know you're getting under a battle. I know you're under a load. There's some of you single mothers under a load. Some of you single daddy's under a load. Some of you under a load. You've been done wrong and spit on and mocked and everything. But can I tell you, those ones standing on the right hand of God who will secure you and who loves you. If you're in this room and you're battered and beaten, I want you to know he'll strengthen you. Just yield to the Holy Spirit. If you're not saved and you're going through battles and you do it, you're going through them too, but you're going through them without Christ. Trust him this morning.